Good morning, students. So today we are going to study the last part of the chapter, that is called fertilization. Now, what is fertilization? Fertilization is the union of the nuclei of the male and the female gametes. That is the union of the nucleus of the male, that is the pollen grain, with the nucleus of the female, that is the ovule. What is the male gamete? The pollen grain, and the female gamete is the ovule, which is inside the ovary. Now we shall study in detail about the ovule. What is this ovule? The ovary, it becomes the fruit. And what is inside this ovary is the ovule. The ovule ultimately becomes the seed. So when you eat the mango, that what are you eating is actually the ovary. And what the seed that you find inside is the ovule. So there can be just one seeded fruits, or there can be several seeded fruits. But the single seeded fruits, that means they had only one ovule, and those fruits which are having several seeds had several ovules inside them. Each ovule has one or two protective coverings known as integuments. Now I come to the structure of the ovule. As you can see here, this dark green portion, this is the integument. Okay, this is the whole structure is that of the ovule, and this dark green portion is the called as the integument. It is the outer covering of the ovule. Now the integuments, you can see they leave an opening over here. There is an opening, and this is known as a micropyle. This opening is known as a micropyle. It is for the entry of the pollen tube carrying the pollen grain. The nucellus encloses the integuments. You can see the next layer here, it's the nucellus. Okay, now this nucellus, what is the function of the nucellus? Is to provide food for the growing embryo. What is the embryo? This light colored portion, or the central portion, this whole thing is known as the embryo. So you have studied three main parts here. One is the outer integument, then you have the nucellus, and then you have the embryo. Now this embryo, or the embryo sac, it basically contains 3+3+1 cells. Now I'll explain to you where are these 3+3+1 cells. Three cells at the micropylar end. Okay, the first three cells are over here. You can see this is a micropyle. As I explained to you, this is known as a micropylar end. Now at the micropylar end, you can see here three of these cells. Now, what are these three cells? The central one is known as the egg cell, and these other two cells, the adjoining other two cells, are known as the synergids. Okay, so this is known as egg cell. These two are known as the synergids. This is at the micropylar end. Now, the opposite end, okay, the opposite end, there are three cells, and the name given to them is antipodal cells, or the antipodals. Okay, so three cells at the opposite side, which are known as antipodal cells. At the center, there is a central cell, a large central cell at the center. Now, what does the central cell contain? It contains two nuclei. Okay, you can see two nuclei over here, and they are known as the polar nuclei. Nucleus is singular, nucleus plural. There are two polar nuclei at the center. So that's the structure of the embryo sac. It contains in total seven cells, three over here. What are they called? The egg cell and the two synergids. At the other side, they are known as the antipodal cells, three of them. At the center, there is a central cell made up of two polar nuclei. Now I shall come to the next part, that is the male part, that is the pollen grain. A mature pollen grain has got a double wall. As you can see, there are two walls. The outer wall is known as the exine, and the inner wall is known as the entine. The nucleus of the pollen grain is divided into the tube nucleus and the generative nucleus. Okay, now the nucleus, it divides into two. There are two nucleus here. One is known as a tube nucleus, and one is known as a generative nucleus. Now this tube nucleus ultimately develops into the pollen tube, and the generative nucleus will later on become the male gamete, okay, the male sperm nuclei. The pollen will germinate only after it falls in the stigma of the same plant species. Now, this is the structure of the pollen. Now, this pollen, when will it germinate? When will it further grow? It will further grow only if it falls on the stigma of a plant of the same species. Okay, otherwise it will just die or degenerate. Only after it falls on the stigma of the same species, then it will further develop. Now we come to the germination of the pollen grain. Now the pollen is stimulated to germinate because of the sugars produced by the stigma. Now once this pollen is fallen on the stigma of the same species, the stigma, it produces certain sugars. Now these sugars will help the pollen to germinate, that is to grow further, to reproduce further. A pollen tube grows from the pollen grain. And what does it carry? It carries the two nucleus. Which are the two nucleus? One is a generative nucleus and one is a tube nucleus. The generative nucleus then divides into two, that is two male gamete nuclei, or they are also known as sperm nuclei. That is, this generative nucleus, it divides into not one but two. Okay, it will divide into two male gamete nuclei. What is the name given to it? Male gamete nuclei, or it is also referred to as the sperm nuclei. How many of them? There will be two of them. And thus the tube nucleus and the two male gamete nuclei share a common cytoplasm. As you can see here, the two sperm nuclei and one is the tube nuclei. All the three, they don't have cell walls. Okay, they don't have cell walls. So they are all having the same cytoplasm, common cytoplasm between them. Okay, so that is why it is called as they share a common cytoplasm. Am I clear here? So here you have learned about the tube nucleus and the two sperm nuclei, or you can see, call it the male gamete nuclei. So this is after it has fallen on the stigma, the tube is further produced. Now this tube, that is further, you can see over here, it has started germinating. Over here also it has started germinating. Okay, and now here there is one that is already entered into the ovule. Pushing through the pollen tube reaches the ovary. From here it grows down and it reaches the ovary. And it pushes through the, as you can see over here, it pushes through the micropyle, which is the opening over here. It will push into it. The tube nucleus degenerates. Once it has reached the micropylar end, this tube nucleus has finished with its function. Okay, what is its function? To develop the tube, okay, and to carry the pollen with it. Okay, so, but then once it has reached over here, its work is over and it disintegrates. The pollen tube then enters one of the synergids. Now here, what is there at the micropylar end? There are the two synergids and the egg cell. So it enters into one of the synergids and releases its two sperm nuclei. Now what is it carrying? What is this pollen tube carrying? It is carrying the two sperm nuclei with it. So it enters over here, it enters into this one of the synergids and it releases its two sperm nuclei. Now what happens to one sperm nuclei? It will fuse with the egg cell, okay, with the egg nucleus, which is at the center over here. And the other one, it will move further towards the center and it will fuse with the two polar nuclei. Remember, the center over here, there are two polar nuclei. So this is known as triple fusion. What is happening in the central cell? It is known as triple fusion because one sperm nuclei is joining with two polar nuclei. So three nuclei are joining together. So that is why it is known as triple fusion. And here what is happening is one of the sperm nuclei is fusing with the egg nuclei. And that is why here one fertilization is taking place. Here at the center, again one fertilization taking place. So it is also referred to as double fertilization. Am I clear? I shall repeat again. the pollen tube, it reaches the ovary. Okay, it goes down, it reaches the ovary. So what does it first come into contact with? The micropylar end. It passes through the micropyle, it enters into one of the synergids. Now what is it carrying? The tube nucleus disintegrates, okay, and what is left? The two sperm nuclei. This one of the sperm nuclei fuses with the egg cell, the other one fuses with the polar nuclei. Now at the center there are three nuclei fusing, so it is known as triple fusion. And here there is one sperm nuclei fusing with the egg cell, and here there is a triple fusion happening. There are two fertilizations taking place, so it is referred to as double fertilization. I hope it is clear. This diagram can very well come for the exam. It's a little different in your textbook. Learn the one in your textbook. Now we shall study, once this fertilization has taken place, then this ovary, it develops into the fruit and the ovules will develop into the seed. Now we shall study what happens to the floral parts. What happens to the other parts of the flower? Now the petals, the stamen, the style, the stigma, all these parts, they wither and fall off. Wither means they will dry and they will fall off. Okay, they will dry and fall off from the plant. The callings might remain. Okay, in some cases the callings might remain in a dry shriveled form. Dried shriveled means a very crumpled form, you can say. As you must have seen in the case of apple, when you eat apples, you see this part at the center. That is known as the callings. Okay, so the example is apple, guava and brinjal. Okay, in brinjal you can see that like the crown shaped thing on the brinjal, that is the callings. Ovary enlarges to form the fruit. The ovarian wall becomes the fruit wall. Okay, so the ovary will form into the fruit, the fleshy fruit, and the ovary wall, okay, the wall of the ovary becomes the fruit wall. Okay, sometimes this ovary wall can be hard, like in the case of walnut, in the case of groundnut. Okay, in that those cases the fruit wall is hard, but some cases it is soft. Now fruit wall is either dry and hard or fleshy. The ovules ultimately become the seeds. Now your homework for today, you shall do progress check, page 45. Review questions, please mark them down. Review questions A and B. You will mark the answers in the textbook. In your notebook work, you will continue with the questions. Last time we stopped at question 3. Now question 4. How many cells are contained in the embryo sac? Explain. The answer is on page 44. It is SAC. Okay. Now question 5. Why is a fertilization called double fertilization? Page 44. From now, the pollen tube up till double fertilization is your answer. Question 6 of the textbook, that is page 46. Question E2 will be question 6. Textbook page 46. Question E3 will be question 7. Read the textbook well, and I shall send you the objective questions of this chapter later on. That's all for today. Have a nice day. Thank you.